9 here.
And this is the only 9mm they have, $36 a box. Some Norma MHP, or hollow points. Too much. We'll move around here. Show you here. This is a double op buck, $37, $19.99, $31.99. These are shotgun rounds. Here's some of this custom defense stuff. If you got $24, you can get a box of that. $44, some Black Cloud. This buckshot is 32. And then if you want to get 250 rounds, $100. We got plenty of 7.62x51 if you're willing to pay $30. That shit down there is 64. They have just, I mean, there's some 308 boat tail. How much is that stuff? $30. Too much. Too much on the 30-06 because it's $30 a box. I got some 223. Too much. Too much. Look at that one's got a bow. If you're willing to pay $34.99. But some X-Tac. This stuff is selling at the shop for $6.99 a box. 17. Too much. What is that? 125 rounds. 5.56, 134. It's too much. Yeah, so that's Dunham's.
Roll call 219. Bear with me. I tried to do this in the house and I got some chickens in the house that are ready to go out in the coop. They don't like to be confined right now. They want to come out here and do their chicken thing. So I came out here, but I got birds chirping, I got deer running around the yard, and plus people are going to work. So bear with me. But leading up to this portion of the video, you've seen some of the places that I've went to. These places didn't have great prices. Some prices were reasonable. If you needed it, that's a reasonable price to get some stuff at. But we're never going to probably see what we saw before the coup, before the civil unrest and things like that. I don't think it's ever going to come back to that level. And if it does, we'll be in good shape. If not, you're going to have to budget accordingly. I've watched a lot of videos on YouTube, and some people are saying there's no ammo shortage. Other people are saying that their place is shortage. What you have to understand, and this is where I can get off talking about it, because a lot of these people that mention these stores are in my area. This chain is in my area. So what you have to understand about this is there is a little bit of validity to these videos, but it's not all boasted out of control like other people say. Okay, it's just not. If a store is doing a high volume of a certain item, especially guns or ammo, and another store is not doing it and there's not a big demand, where do you think their stuff is going to get shipped to? It's going to get shipped to this place that is selling the hell out of something, and then everything else left over is going to trickle down to the store that's not. That's just the way these places work. Why would you ship your stuff down to a place that is not doing a high volume in sales and starve a store that is really selling the hell out of a product? That doesn't make sense. So there's some balance there. Plus you have shipping costs. A lot of people don't understand. Trucks take gasoline. Gasoline is at a high price at this point. So there's a little bit of a fluctuation in the market. Being on the side of the gun counter, this is the kind of aspect that I see. Being just a gun owner and just walking into shops trying to find stuff, that's a different perspective. There's different perspectives here that we're dealing with in the supply and demand of ammunition and firearms. Okay, I'm not going to be buying what some of this stuff is priced at. Other people will. They have to do this. They have to do that. There is still an ammo crunch. There is still some a stranglehold on the market. Before the coup and then going into the first part of it, we used to get emails all the time, and I used to look at those emails. Those emails contain certain layouts that Vista would put out, stuff that Hornady would put out and talk about this stuff before they started making cringy videos. That's my job. But looking at that and looking at the markets, they were predicting 5 years. 5 years for the market to level off. That wasn't to get back to pricing that we were used to. That was just to fulfill orders that were that they were so backed up on that they couldn't produce enough of it. You know, it takes a lot to start expanding places, you know what I'm saying, and bringing in new workers and new payroll and all that jazz. They're 5 years behind to just level off the market and fulfill commitments that they had. And then to put stuff on the shelves for consumers to consume. You know, there's a lot of things that they had to do to get to the point where we're at now. And we're about 3.5, almost 4 years into the huge crunch that we saw just a short time ago. So, I mean, that prediction of 5 years is off. I don't see the market leveling off. I do see the market leveling off on firearms, though. There's a difference there. At one point, I was looking for a Glock 26. Could not find that gun for the longest time. Found one, $700. Found another one, $750. Looked at a local gun shop, $800. I mean, that was at the time at the height. You know what I'm saying? And I didn't think the market was going to fluctuate that bad. Then the gun counter got busy. Then I had no guns at all. People that do YouTube videos, like Marksman TV, go look at my channel list. He pulls a lot of that data because he's an FFL. He gets that data. FFLs get a lot of data sent to them when they sign up for emails. I think you can sign up for some of them, but a lot of the market stuff, you have to go out and find on your own. Other times they just send it to FFLs and tell them about their struggles, especially their dealers and all that jazz that go along with it. What they can have, what they can't have. Right now, they can probably get whatever gun that you're looking for, they can probably get it. The problem with that is you're not going to be able to shoot it because there's still, you know, demand on ammunition. And that's why I say there's still crunch. There's still crunch going on, especially if you're getting into concealed carry. A lot of people don't understand. You got to pay for these courses. So not only are you paying for the courses, you're paying for the ammunition, then you're paying for your firearm. That's a huge budget to have. And I'll put this on there. We were at the plateau of firearms here a couple of years ago. Now it's on the decline. So you're not getting the extra couple of bucks to pay a bill or an extra couple of bucks on a better gun for a trade-in. Those days are starting to pass us. By. You might still catch somebody off balance there on some kind of trade-in or something like that, but the market is starting to drop for guns. And I'll give you an example. The G2s, another example, the G2s, all the G-series guns in this place, $250, $275, $300. That's what they were. Back when you couldn't find a gun, those guns were commanding almost $500. That's not what those guns are priced at. That's not the normal price of those guns. So now you see the fluctuation. I found a Glock 17, a Gen 4, for $499. Good luck trying to find that 2 years ago at that price. So guns are starting to fall off. And I've watched a lot of other people talking about the data that they're getting, that they can talk to their dealers, and they can buy these guns. So there's a lot of ins and outs, especially if you're a new gun owner, you're getting into firearms, you're really liking it, and you want to take the next steps in gun ownership. So there's a lot of things that have to do. The ammo crunch is still there. Just because it's in your store doesn't mean it's not like that in the next place over. Because I've gone to one place and found a deal on ammunition, gone to another place, same stuff, $20 more. And I'm still seeing 9mm for $34 a box. That's outrageous. That's not how much that stuff is, especially for just some range ammunition, you know, some full metal jackets. That's expensive. That's expensive for me anyways, because we weren't paying those prices, you know, 5 years ago. Those prices were non-existent. So it all depends what the market is commanding, and it all depends about your stores. You know, A lot of these people are talking about, oh, I go to this store. Well, I have that store in my area and they don't have shit. So what is that telling me? That's telling me your store is doing such a high volume that they're shipping that stuff there first. And then we're getting what trickles left over or what they can afford after they're waiting for the return on everything that they ship to these other stores. So there's a lot of different working parts here. But there still is a crunch. There's still things that are going on. There's still things that are not right with the market. What you are going to see, you're going to see more availability. And another thing that I'll let you a secret on is used guns. Go to your local. Do you have a lot of used guns here in my area? I don't know how your area is on all this stuff we're talking about here, but in my area, no used guns. And if they are, they're Derringers, Rough Riders, things like that. Things, I mean, if you need it, it's better than not having anything at that point. You know, deer are running through the woods here. But looking at the different aspects there about that is, you know, the people that bought these guns in the beginning of all this turmoil that we've seen across the country, they're not giving up their guns. And I think they figured that out, whether they're liberal, they're in the middle, conservative, or just didn't like guns in the begin with. This is a different kind of story, because I was hoping to catch a couple of deals when everything settled down, there's nothing going on, and people started trading in those guns because they didn't think they need them anymore. We're not seeing that kind of turnover. At least I'm not seeing it in my area. I don't know about your area. Start talking, creating conversations, talking about in your local gun shops and see what they're seeing, what's coming through the door, what's in that counter, you know, space where all the used guns are, and what's the price on these guns? Because again, you're not going to get what they were going for just a few years ago. The ammo crunch is still here. It all depends on your area. It all depends on the supply and demand that certain store is commanding. We walk through there, there's a lot of stuff on a shelf. There's a lot of stuff on the shelves. You know, 30-30, there's shotgun rounds. All that stuff was way overpriced. Again, at the other store, 7.62x39, more boxes than I could count. Still, just not a good price. I'm not paying those bills I'm not paying those prices for that type of ammunition. It's just not going to happen. I've been, again, stocking ammunition up. But if you need it, you're going to have to create a budget for it. Don't go broke. Don't do what the government does, where they bloat budgets and you know what I'm saying, they end up going in the hole. Don't do that to yourself. Don't do that to yourself. Budget accordingly. If you need it, pick up a box. If you need to shoot it, shoot a half a box. Save up again, get a new box, shoot the rest of that other box, start conserving. Or if you come across that deal, I still see limits on boxes of how much you can buy. That's still a thing. Used to be you can just go in there and have handfuls of ammunition and walk out the door. We're still seeing limits, I guess, in my area of what you can and cannot get. You know, you can only have 6 boxes of this, 6 boxes of handgun ammunition, 2 boxes of rifle ammunition, or vice versa. So there's still a lot of things that are getting pinched there, because these manufacturers understand that these people are trying to supply stuff. They're catching up, they're behind. And I don't know what else to tell you guys. They put out the videos, they're telling you they're working hard, they're telling you they're rolling ammunition, throwing in there and shipping it off. I get it, it is what it is. But I will make this warning to those companies. The shit I've been buying is not American made. I had to go research companies to see where this stuff is made, get some perspective of where this stuff is coming from. You know, I don't want to put stuff through my gun that's not going to work, that's not going to help me when I need it the most. But let this be a lesson to all these American-made companies, whether it's Winchester, Federal, you know, Fiocchi, all these people, you know what I'm saying? They're filling those spots where your ammunition is not. And a lot of these companies, they're from overseas. So you better put that into your perspective, because if I see a box of American Eagle, you know, that's priced, and I see another one of these companies that is the same, on the same level, but $5 cheaper, where do you think you're going to go? You're going to have to budget that stuff, unless you're just going to pay the extra $5 and not care. But you have to understand, we just saw Winchester have a pretty good return on some ammunition that was faulty. You know, me and my son were looking at ammunition the other day. The bullets were packed deep for some 5.56. I've never seen 5.56 bullets packed that deep into the cartridge. So you really have to look at this ammunition. The more and more these people, you know, start fluctuating this onto the market, the more risk that you have that it's not going to be as good as it used to be back in the day. So that's another aspect you have to look. It's great to see all this stuff on the shelves, but if you start having problems, like I was shooting some ammunition a month or so ago, and I had to stop shooting, you know, clear my firearm, take it apart and look at it, because it just wasn't sounding right. I didn't know if I had a squib load or not in the barrel itself, because it was, you know, it wasn't a normal sounding sound when the round went off. So you gotta look at quality control for this, just like firearms. You know, a lot of people talk about certain companies and about their quality control. The same thing goes with ammunition. You have to watch out for that stuff. So again, research your ammunition. If people are having recalls on their ammunition, make sure you look at it. Make sure you look at the UPCs and match them up. That's why I just don't take boxes of ammunition and throw them into an ammo can. Or if I do, I keep the box just in case there's a recall on ammunition. There's a lot of ins and outs of being a gun owner, because let's face it, you don't want to have an accident. You know, that would be devastating to you. You know, it could be life threatening. So there's a lot of aspects that come into the ammo game and how you're going to play it. Whether you're going to pay the premium price, or you're going to hold off, or you just have no option, but you better budget yourself and not overpay too much. I've overpaid for some ammunition. When I was down in Claremore, Oklahoma, I paid a little bit more than I wanted to do for some 6.5 Creedmoor because I had a gun. But now I look at it, I come back up here, and guess what? I found it cheaper. Actually, I found it about $20 cheaper than what I bought down there. The ammo game is something that you gotta kind of balance out in your lifestyle and your budget. And you go search out this information. Don't take it from me or other people on YouTube. Go talk to your local gun shops. Go talk to these big box stores. Talk to them. Look at what their supply is. Try and get a gauge on it. I mean, there's so much that goes into it that you should pay attention to it, because it's valid. It's important. But don't go around and start saying, well, there's no ammo shortage, because there is. There is in certain spots, especially when I don't see American-made stuff that I've been shooting for years. And now there's some other kind of ammunition on the shelf. And I'll make a video about this ammunition. It seems to be really good. It seems to be worthy of being shot. And it's reliable. So we'll have to look at all these different aspects. But I think a lot of it's a little bit construed. There's validity there. But a little bit's construed into just a view. And we have to separate, you know, just trying to get views, to really the big aspects on the market itself. So there's some things that go into it that you should pay attention to, especially if you're a new gun owner and you're in your infancy of shooting firearms and getting really getting into owning it. I will throw this last little tidbit in before we go. Shotgun ammunition. I didn't find affordable stuff at one place, but I did find it in another. If you've graduated from pistols and you're pretty good with them, you're responsible with it, look at a shotgun. Right now, there's shelves around here filled with shotguns, tons of them. I mean, I could throw a stone and hit one. You know, that's how many there are. That might be another thing to get into. Look at shotguns. Not only that, it still gives you trigger time. Your shoulder might hurt, but it's still going to give you trigger time, and it's still going to make you efficient in creating another aspect of the firearm game and expanding out there and getting another skill, which I think a lot of people kind of just, you know, pass shotguns off as being fuddish, but they're really efficient in what they do. So there's a ton of things that can go in there and go into this little problem that we're having with the supply of ammunition. It's there. Don't get me wrong. They're right. It's there. But are you willing to pay the price for it? Are you willing to take a training course and damn near pay more for a training course than you are for the ammunition than you are for the training course, and vice versa with the firearm that you're going to use? There's a lot of things that go into it. Research it for yourself. I highly suggest that you do that. Don't listen to me or anybody else. Go research it for yourself. Talk to your locals in your area and see what you come out with. Put this stuff down in the comments. Let's create a conversation of what you're seeing in your area. Let's get a gauge. Let's make our own data, not rely on everybody else's. If we all come together and compile our statistics of what we're seeing price-wise, what kind of ammunition that's on our shelves, we can really make a determination, especially if we go out and shoot some of this new stuff that just shows up out of nowhere, whether it's good or not, and it's worth the price to pay, or we have to pay a little bit of that premium for the stuff that we've always known to shoot. So hopefully that kind of breaks this stuff down. It's going to be a long video, and I don't expect everybody to stay for the end, but I do want to thank all my old and my new subscribers and just the people that zip through. I greatly do appreciate it. Please don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Do it for everybody you watch on YouTube. Do it for my channel. I would greatly appreciate it. Leave a comment down below. And like always, guys, we'll catch you on the next one.